tear apart a final table, and now they're going to rip into each other. It's WPT's Bad Boys of Poker 2 tonight on the World Poker Tour.
The World Poker Tour is a series of 17 international poker tournaments featuring the biggest games.
Gus Hansen, poker the Bad Boys title.
The greatest players and the largest payouts on the planet. Los Angeles, six of poker's best are fighting it out for the right to be called the baddest of the bad tonight on the World Poker Tour.
Hi, everyone. Welcome to the World Poker Tour. We're at the Commerce Casino in Los Angeles for the second edition of the WPT's wildest tournament, the Bad Boys of Poker. I'm Mike Sexton.
And I'm Vince Van Patten. And Mike, tonight we are going to see some of the greatest players on the planet, bar none, but also some of the greatest trash talkers on the planet. So you know what? I've come prepared. I have brought the WPT earplugs, you know, so I don't have to listen to them.
But in case you ever find yourself at the same table as Tony G, getting those earplugs might not be a bad idea. Because when it comes to trash talking, Tony G is ruthless. He'll be in seat one.
Okay, and sitting next to the Australian airbag, in seat number two, a man also known for his mouth. In fact, that is his nickname, The Mouth, the very accomplished poker professional, Mike Matisau. Next to Mike Matisau, the great Phil Hellmuth. Now, he is known for his anger. He is known for berating players, along with his poker wins. The poker brat is back, Phil Hellmuth, seat number three.
Like him or not, make no mistake, the guy is a phenomenal poker talent. Now, our field of trash talkers would not be complete without a true master of the game, and I'm talking about Min, the master Win, the four-time player of the year, will be in seat four.
He is great. He not only walks the walk, but he can talk the talk. All right, next to Min, a guy that's been on the tour just for a few years, but what a reputation. He loves to push his opponents around. He's from Los Angeles, Jean-Robert Ballon. You're going to like this guy.
And rounding out the field tonight is the reigning Bad Boys champion. He's here to defend his title, the Great Dane, the winningest player ever on the World Poker Tour, Gus Hansen. But Vince, unlike the other players at the table, Gus is not really a trash talker. He lets his chips do the talking.
No, he doesn't trash talk, but he plays trash hands, and he makes them win. It's amazing.
Well, we're about to get started. It's all on the line. A WPT title, bragging rights, that $25,000 entry into the WPT World Championship. Here we go.
All these players are starting out with 250,000 in chips.
Oh, this could be an obnoxious night. I tell you something, Bad Boys about to begin the glorious night of insults, bluff, and slandering.
Former world champion Phil Hellmuth Jr. has drawn the button. That means first action will be on the defending Bad Boys champion, Gus Hansen.
The trash man looks down at the 9-6 offsuit, doesn't play. And now the Australian airbag in this curious Japanese outfit lays down his queen 7.
Mike Matisau folds. Hellmuth quickly folds.
Men with queen 8 in the small blind. He's called it, but over the top for Jean-Robert.
He has raised it with an 8-4 offsuit here.
Phil wants to win this so bad that he offered us 100,000 each just to blow off to him. We all turn him down.
Now, Mike Matisau is out of the pot, you notice, but he has not stopped talking.
And on the first offer for the 25,000 seat.
Well, Men is calling the raise. So here we go. A battle of the blinds taking place here. And flop comes 6-5 deuce. Jean-Robert flopped a two-way straight draw, as we say. Action on Men.
Yeah, Men flopping nothing.
He checks.
And let's see if Jean will take a shot at this.
Pretty good flop for his hand.
Mm-hmm.
And he's going to bet 20,000.
Yes, he does. Stiff bet.
Well, Men's going to let it go.
Jean-Robert Ballond taking his first pot this evening.
He is happy to be here, Vince. He's the least known of these players, that's for sure. But certainly has the Bad Boy image. You got to say that for him.
And looking very fashionable this evening with that ski hat.
Where I come from, guys who wear those ski hats go in to rob banks.
Well, right there, Jean-Robert kind of robbed a bank right there, taking that first pot.
He did. He stole it.
With just 8-4.
You know, everybody I know calls this guy Bobby Ballon, so forget the Jean-Robert. We're going to call him Bobby, too.
Well, it gives him a little touch of class, perhaps, if you say Jean Robert. You know. All right, decision's going to be on the Great Dane once again, Gus Hansen. He's got King 5 this time.
Lays it down.
And there's the Aussie, Tony G, a great talker. He goes out.
These are my normal hands.
Manus already complained about his cards, Vince.
Phil Hellmuth wants no part of it. He goes out. We're back to the two guys.
Well, Min the Master limping in with ace 3 of diamonds here.
And Jean Robert says, I call. Here's the flop. Now look at this.
Min the Master has flopped the nuts, the very best hand possible, the ace high flush.
And he quickly checked it. He's going to try to trap Jean Robert, who has top pair.
He's flopped two jacks.
Yep.
I'd bet also after my opponent checked me. He bets 12,000.
Min the Master with a little revenge time here, perhaps.
Min's going to raise it. He's not going to slow play the nut flush. Trying to give off the impression that perhaps he just has a dry ace, as we say. Mm-hmm. Just the lone ace of diamonds. And this is what Bobby's got to try to figure out. Is Min on a draw? Can he really beat these jacks? Is he just trying to take the pot away from me? I'm going to call him and find out.
He's got him on the hook. And look at this, a seven of diamonds. This could be bad for Min. This could slow the action down, of course.
It's got to scare Bobby a little bit.
Yeah. Now, he checked once again.
Had Min been on just the draw, he's made his hand now.
Will Jean Robert get out of line here?
And Bobby is not investing any more money here. He's wisely checked it.
Check.
And again, Min the Master checking the cinch. Check, check. It goes.
Min was hoping he would bet at the pot, but Jean didn't take the bait. Probably get the needle from his opponents for not getting more value out of that hand.
Bob escaping there. And Min taking his first pot. A little disgusted that he couldn't suck this guy out for a little bit more.
Jean did not go for it. Give him credit for standing out of the Master's trap there.
Nice, man. Min, where's the rest of that pot, Min? Where's the rest of that pot, Min?
I saw the rest of that pot walking down the street.
Oh, boy. I'll tell you, there'll be no mercy at this table, Vince, for anybody that slips up and makes any kind of mistake, I can tell you.
Save those traps for the rookies, Min.
Well, this is not only a tough table in terms of talk, Vince, but in talent alone. Tremendous poker skills at this table.
No doubt about it. Let's go back down to the table on Phil Hellmuth, who's been very quiet. He's got ace 3 this time.
Couldn't keep him down.
He's going to raise it here. Comes in for 20,000.
Min out. Jean Robert going out. And now around to Gus Hansen with the button. He's got queen 10 of hearts.
He's got position. You know Gus likes to play this style of hand, but do you want to call a raise when the guy who raised it was the first to act?
It's like I feel Gus is giving you protection. Instead of me playing, Gus is going to play.
Well, Gus is going to make the call.
I'll give Gus a lot of credit. He has
to take this hand up against you, Phil.
Tony G just getting his mouth warmed up. He goes out. Mike out. No, it's two-way action. Hellmuth versus Hansen. Two superstars in the game.
Also two aggressive bettors. Let's see what happens here.
And the flop's King 10 deuce.
Phil raised before the flop. Will he bet on the flop? No, he checks.
Caught nothing. Now, of course, Gus hit his pair of tens.
Well, you see the look on Gus's face. Surprised Hellmuth would check after the flop. He's trying to figure out if Phil's trapping him here.
How do you get a read on Phil when you're doing that? You're cupping your entire face. You got glasses, you got the cap. You only see a little speck of his nose.
Well, you check to Gus Hansen. He's got second pair. He's going to bet it. That's what he's doing here, 28,000.
Does Hellmuth want to stick around? No, he goes out, and just like that, Gus Hansen with a pair of tens.
When I grow up, I want to be as good as you, Gus.
And look at this. Insults flying by the mouth.
Probably not going to happen, Mike.
And Gus hitting the back with...
for sure, I'm not going to grow up. That's for sure. But as far as being as good as you, you an idiot.
Mike, the correct English is you're an idiot, not you're a idiot.
Oh,
all
man.
Right, I apologize.
All right, send the kids to bed because we got more WPT's Bad Boys of Poker right after this.
You really want a tournament, you're really getting down there, and you start to sweat a little bit.
Oh, no. It's like his pants are on fire.
Those are the moments that define greatness in poker. All the heat, all the pressure. I live for those moments.
I'll win it, because I'm not going to be talking much today. I'm just going to concentrate. You're not going to hear much out of me.
Got it! Fifth, he caught the king. Well, look at him. He's going for third.
I'm going to be focused on the table, and that's why I think I'm going to win.
Welcome back to WPT's Bad Boys of Poker 2. Can reigning bad boy Gus Hansen hold on to his title? Well, let's get back to the action and find out.
I'm Vince Van Patten alongside Mike Sexton. Very dignified final six here at Bad Boys number two.
This little wussy over here just gives you pops.
And right now, Gus Hansen has about $350,000. He is the chip leader. Action on men. Throws away eight deuce. Jean Robert out.
Over to Gus. Gus looks at 9-3 offsuit, lays it down.
If you want to pick him off,
I don't care.
And here's the hot air balloon from Australia, Tony G.
You wouldn't want to follow the worst
hand. Says, I'm out, but Matisau calls it.
You bluff me and I have any hint of it, it's going to be this quick. Boom.
And he's only up against Phil Hellmuth, who looks down at a wired pair of eights here.
Well, Phil is going to raise it, looks like, yep. Raises it 15,000 more. Matisau quickly calls.
He's not going anywhere.
Come on, Bobby. I don't limp and just fold.
Two-way action. Here we go.
Oh, what a flop for Matisau. He flopped a pair of nines and a flush draw and checks. And Hellmuth checks the two eights right behind him.
A jack on the turn. Open it a straight draw. Check, check again. And a deuce on the river. Now it's on Matisau, of course.
He's going to bet 15,000 here.
I'm pretty sure you have me, buddy.
With just the nines, and he gets paid off.
Wow. Hellmuth says, I'm sure you have me, but I just want to see what you got. What poker instincts by Hellmuth there? He checked on the flop with two eights, checked on the turn with an open end straight and a pair, and did right both times.
Oh, two eights. Wait, I have a nine. Nine.
Oh, boy. Don't give this man any encouragement.
Matisau sticking the needle in him a little bit there.
Well, if it came seven high, he might have moved in.
Now you see Hellmuth is on steam watch right now. Steam coming out of that cap. Just a little bit.
Of course, you got to recognize that Phil Hellmuth is the most fun player in poker to needle and to try to get on tilt. All the players love to do it to him.
So the very dignified Mike the Mouth Matisau taking his first pot here on the Bad Boys.
Hey, Phil, let him see you over here, buddy.
It is like we're playing on a street corner here.
Oh, boy.
Well, did Michael Jordan win the NBA?
All right, back down on the table.
He carried a team.
On Mr. Gentleman, Mike Matisau, he goes out with queen six.
Phil Hellmuth picking up two kings here.
Wow.
There you go.
Bets 20,000. What a spot to get him. Everybody thinks he's on tilt, and he picks up a monster hand.
Getting more aggressive.
He's got the big one now right behind him. Men the master, queen ten of clubs. He's got a decision. He is going to call it. Now Jean Robert going out with 4-3 of hearts.
Over to Gus Hansen.
Wow, I'd like to see Gus's two cards.
Got five deuce offsuit folds.
The Aussie blowhard goes out. So two-way action.
Phil Hellmuth with two kings. Min the master with the queen 10. And it's come queen jack 9.
Uh-oh.
We can see some fireworks here. Phil has the over pair, man, the top pair, and an open-end straight draw.
Phil is quickly going to check this.
Wow, I'm surprised by that. And I'm surprised man checks right behind him.
Turn card, five of diamonds.
Again, Phil checks.
Yes, he does. Now, will men come out? Yes, he does. He's going to bet $25,000.
Well, you have to think you have the best hand when the guy checks twice, do you?
And a quick call by Hellmuth. Here we go to the river.
A king comes off. Hellmuth has made three kings, but Men has made a straight, and Hellmuth checks again.
This could be a complete train wreck. And here comes Men the master, who hit his straight. He bets 60,000, and a quick call by Hellmuth.
Men's going to show him the straight. Hellmuth's going to bite the dust.
I had top pair, Phil.
Top pair.
I believe had he or Men bet earlier in that hand, Phil Hellmuth could have very well gone broke on this hand.
Phil, you didn't want to make trips in this hand.
Listen to the cackling at the table. You got to love the Aussie. I mean, he's like a hyena with his cackling. Tony G enjoying Phil Hellmuth's pain. Phil is definitely on suicide watch after that.
Well, Phil trying to remain calm, cool, and collected, but inside,
he didn't pick that bluff off.
It's hotter than a furnace at a steel plant. I can tell you that right now.
You know what Phil was doing? He was playing his hand like an amateur, playing his free kings. He wasn't worried.
Oh, Tony G, man. He's trying to make Phil Hellmuth stew. That's what he's doing.
By the way, he hasn't played a hand tonight, and he's having more fun than anyone. Action on Phil Hellmuth.
Deeply on the short stack in this tournament now. Lays his hand down.
Men out. So is Jean Robert. Now Gus Hansen with the button in front. He's got ace queen.
Well, he's got a very nice hand on the button. He's going to raise it. Comes in for 18,000.
Not the modern age title.
And the Aussie airbag has king four. He still hasn't played a pot. He goes out.
Mike Matafel looks at two fives, and he moves all in with them, Vince.
Yep, he sure does.
Wow, that's about $250,000.
Hold on, Mike's all in. Silence, Phil.
And listen to the conversation on the side. Helmuth now.
Well, look at the problem Gus Hansen has right here. Gus is the chip leader. Trying to figure out why the guy would go all in if he had a real big hand here. Wouldn't he make a smaller raise than this?
Boys, Gus is contemplating calling Mike's all in bet here. Let's enjoy this.
Many times when a guy makes an over bet, you scratch your head and you say, why would he do it? If he had a big hand, wouldn't he raise a smaller amount? Wouldn't he want me in this pot? It's going to cost him about $230,000 to make this call. Now, he could afford to make it and not be eliminated from the tournament. But do you want to gamble like that, especially when you got the nice chip lead right now?
Well, he'd love to put a sock in the mouth of Mike Matisau, take him out of this event.
Because of the WPT hole cam brought to you by Budweiser, we can see that we have a race situation. It's two over cards versus an under pair.
$232 more, that's a lot of money.
That's a very good thinker at the table. Excellent at putting opponents on a hand. Mike Matisau does not want Gus to make this call. He knows at best he'll be in a race situation for his money. He'd be happy just to take the pot right down here.
Thought Gus was maybe monkeying around with the button, but Gus has a big hand, ace queen.
Just for the heck of it.
Well, Gus is going to make the call. Gambling Gus Hansen going for it here. And Mike Matisau, normally very talky. I'm guessing if he loses this pot, he'll be as quiet as a church mouse.
I knew he's calling off his chips as best as a coin flip. Wow.
If he wins it, we'll see a new version of the Chatty Cathy doll.
Yeah, the great Gus Hansen has an opportunity to silence the mouth. Will he do it? Five cards to come.
I love it. I love my play. I don't care.
Well, Vince, win or lose this pot, I like the call Gus Hansen made here. He could afford to make the call. He analyzed the hand correctly, in my mind. Just didn't put Mike on that big of a hand. Otherwise, why would he make such a big raise? In the meantime, it's two fives for Matisau. His tournament life on the line here. He must win this pot to stay alive.
Will the mouth be silenced? We will see. Here comes the flop.
It's 9-3-3.
He clenched his fists. He likes that flop.
Well, Gus could backdoor flush to win the pot. Otherwise, he needs an ace or a queen to win it.
I'm only 4-1 favorite now.
Here comes the turn.
Well, a nine comes off.
Another good card for him.
We are off to the river. Gus Hansen must catch an ace or a queen to win this pot and eliminate Mike Matisau.
Now I'm about 8-1 favorite.
Calculating the odds as he goes along. Here's the river card. He's done it.
All of a sudden, Mike Matisau looks like a genius here. But in truth, he just got lucky and won the race.
Hello, Gus.
Get out the duct tape. Matisau wins another.
Everything all right, Gus?
Pretty good.
Well, over $500,000 in that pot. So Mike Matisau takes the chip lead in this tournament.
The table was rooting for you, I promise.
The thing with these bets is, I knew Gus is going to try to stack all his chips and hope to be a coin flip because he don't have a clue about poker.
We know what you do with chips when you have a lot of them.
Well, in truth, I think Gus made a very good call there. I think he made the right call.
Usually what happens when I don't win the coin flips, I'm still in the tournament. If you lose it, you're out.
That is a very good statement.
Normally, players don't have to justify their every move, but at this table, you got the greats having to do just that this evening.
Hello, Phil.
All right, we're starting to crank it up now, Vince. Stay tuned. More exciting action from the bad boys of poker in just a moment.
Basically, a very competitive nature. Anything, gamble on everything. I don't like to lose.
The Commerce Casino is the friendliest card casino in the world. We cater to all players, even bad boys. John Robert Ballon has played here for years.
I'm at Commerce probably 4 or 5 months a year.
Thank you, sir.
The best way to survive at a poker game at the Commerce with the bad boy, number one, I would say review your WPT tapes and pick up some tells on these guys because you're going to need all the help you can get.
Welcome
back to the World Poker Tour. Six players remain at the Bad Boys of Poker at the L.A. Commerce Casino.
And Phil Hellmuth right now on the severe short stack. Only got 56,000 left. Everybody else has over 200,000.
And Gus Hansen getting chopped in half there. He's got about 200 grand now. All right, action on the great Gus Hansen. He looks down at 6-4, a little discouraged after that last hand. He goes out. Kimono Kid going away.
Over to Mike Manasau. Right. He's going to come in with a raise here with the 5-4 diamonds. Makes it 18,000 to go. But look at this, Vince. Phil Hellmuth has picked up two kings.
Again.
This could be it, boys and girls.
Well, they couldn't come at a better time for him. He's on a short stack here.
I'm all in, 37,000.
But of course, Hellmuth pushes hard. He's gone all in.
Well, you can't blame Phil for going all in here.
Nope.
Ben and John Robert get out of the way.
Back on Matisau.
There's about 88,000 in the pot. Going to cost Matisau 37,000 more to call.
You got to call him.
Will you be quiet for a minute?
Getting well over 2-1 odds on his money, but
you're taking the exposure.
Go ahead, Morty Miles.
And everybody else encouraging him to go for it, but they're his chips, not theirs.
I love you, Philly.
You love him, or you love his money?
And yes, he gets the call.
And right now, Phil Hellmuth, a 4-1 favorite to double up here.
No, I got the 4.
Two kings versus the 5-4 diamonds.
And Hellmuth prays that his kings are going to hold up.
Well, the last time Phil had two kings, he got beat by a queen 10. Will it happen again?
The thing is, I'm kind of rooting for him to win because I've already lost with kings once and eights against 9-7, so the sick part of me is rooting to lose this pot.
He's going to be on his best behavior when he goes out.
Watch your shins. The chair might go flying.
And Vince, you better get those earplugs out in case Matisau wins this pot.
I've got a feeling you're going to win.
I don't know who will be screaming the loudest, Matisau or Hellmuth.
Here we go with the first three.
Well, it's queen six deuce.
I got the three draw and the backdoor flush draw.
The three will win the pot for him. He could also hit two diamonds in a row and make a flush to win it.
He's drawing dead if the three hits.
Hellmuth smiling. He knows it's never easy to win these pots. It doesn't matter how strong your hand looks.
And there's the turn. It's a six. It pairs the board. That's good for Phil.
That was a very good
card. Well, we are down to the river. Mike Matisau must catch a three if he wants to eliminate Phil Hellmuth from this tournament.
But it's still the same.
Well, it's the eight of diamonds. So Phil Hellmuth is going to double up and stay alive.
I like that 15-1 now.
And Vince, once again, they've all got chips. So Phil's got to be saying to himself, finally, a little justice.
Not without having to sweat it just a little bit. Phil Hellmuth.
It's early yet.
Taking the kings, doubling up.
And Vince, the blinds are going up.
Yes, they are. Place of poker is now $5,000 and $10,000 for the blinds.
Action's going to be on the mouth.
He's got king four. He goes out. Phil looking down at 6-3 of clubs.
Lays it down.
Men out. Now Jean-Robert Ballon with A7.
And it just makes it 20,000, the minimum raise possible with the ace high.
And Gus Hansen with Dolly Parton, 9-5.
He lays it down.
Is it total 10?
And now the only one to beat, Tony G. He's got king 9.
Minimum a call and perhaps a raise.
Well, he's going to make the call, getting good pot eyes to do so. So it's king 9 for Tony, A7 for Jean-Robert.
Here's the flop, it's king jack 3. Tony's hit the kings.
And he's checked it.
Quickly checked it, and Jean-Robert with just ace high. Look at the guts, though, he's betting 30,000.
Well, he's going to make a stab at it.
He gets a quick call by Tony with the top pair.
No surprise Tony didn't raise there.
There's a queen on the turn. Gives a straight draw to Jean-Robert, inside straight draw.
40.
Tony leads right out on the turn now and bets 40,000. Doesn't want to give Jean-Robert a free card that could beat him. Both players have a straight draw. A 10 would make them both a straight. But obviously Jean-Robert would have a better hand with the ace high straight. But is he going to put the 40,000 in there to try to catch it?
And for the first time tonight, the king of gab, Tony G, very quiet. Mums it up here when he has a hand.
Jean-Robert trying to figure out why the guy just called on the flop and then let out and bet on the turn. Wondering if he raised it, could he take the pot away from Tony here?
I feel I'm in front, but I'm going to let it go, Tony.
Does that mean you're going to pass?
When you're in front, you shouldn't
fall. I feel you're in front,
Tony. Finally, Jean-Robert going out.
You got to choose one count.
Nothing like a gracious winner, folks.
Can I choose one?
No.
Gotta love that giggle.
This is going to be humiliating.
Oh, he's trying to act like Jean Robert laid down the best hand.
But he felt he was in front.
When in fact, we know that didn't happen, but it just shows you.
That sounds like Phil.
He's just trying to stir the pot and aggravate him now.
When I'm in front, when I think I'm in front, I just put my money in.
These boys are bad to the bone, and there's a lot more to come, so stick around.
I am a pretty big guy. I'm 6'6", 265 pounds. It's pretty intimidating. I think that my size probably helps when I'm trying to be the boss of the table.
Lots of fun and mirth continue here at the Commerce Casino, the largest poker casino in the world. These are the bad boys we thought they were. Unabashed taunting going on here. Action on men. He quickly goes out.
Jean Robert folds.
Now Gus Hansen with Queen 10 right now. And he is going to pop it up. Makes it 28,000 to go into Tony G, who goes out with 10-7. Mike going out. Now Phil Hellmuth.
I'm all in.
He's got A6. He says, I'm going all in. That has silenced the table.
Now, this is reading your opponent, folks. When you can pull the trigger for all your chips with A6 offsuit and feel confident you've got the best hand, that tells me you can play the game, and certainly Phil Hellmuth can.
It does seem like he had a read on Gus. Gus, we know, with just Queen 10.
I mean, Phil's problem is that Gus is a defender when he's got money out in the pot.
Well, it's an additional 114,000. I mean, this could be a bigger mistake than Donald Trump's hairdo.
Well, there's 180,000 in the pot, going to cost Gus 114,000 to call, meaning he's only getting about 3-2 odds on his money. Generally, with this kind of hand, you like a little more odds than that, but.
And you'd like to be able to see your opponent a little bit. Look at Hellmuth. You can't. He's disappeared there. He puts his hands over his face, the cap.
Is there any reason to lay it down?
Gus is hoping that Phil has something like 2 sevens or 2 eights where he'd be in a race situation.
And Gus rationalizing why he should call, justifying, you know, thinking of ways to put his money in the pot.
That's what's unique about Gus. Most players are folding or thinking of ways to get out of a pot. Gus is trying to figure out a way he can get in it.
Well, he's won 3 WPT titles. Man thinks he can do no wrong. Why not?
Don't forget he's the defending Bad Boys champion as well. He's been in the winner's circle on the World Poker Tour more than any other player.
All right. It's not a big deal.
There it is. Oh,
yes, he's
gambling.
Giving
Gus Hansen going for it.
Giving the action to Phil Hellmuth.
These are the kind of calls he's famous for, Vince. He calculates pot odds. He thinks it's okay to make the kind of call with this hand. He has done it. And right now, Phil Hellmuth, not quite a 3-2 favorite to win this pot. So, according to pot odds, Gus made the right decision again here. Now let's see if he can get lucky, win the pot, and eliminate Phil Hellmuth.
Phil Hellmuth would be our sixth place finisher here if he should get a little unlucky. Mattisau calculating the odds in his head. Here we go with the first three.
And the flop is ace, queen, five.
Uh-oh.
Hellmuth has flopped top pair. Gus Hansen has flopped second pair.
Phil Hellmuth in a nice place right now with two cards to come.
Gus is looking for a queen or a 10 or two running cards to give him a straight.
Crowd on their feet at the Bad Boys event in L.A.
Turn an ace and end this race.
Turn an ace to end this
race. A four comes off on the turn. So we are down to the river. And right now, Phil Hellmuth, a big favorite, nearly 9-1 to win this pot. Gus Hansen must catch a queen or a 10 to eliminate Phil Hellmuth from his table. Well, a four spade comes on the river. Phil Hellmuth has doubled up.
Phil, you're the champion.
And the defending champion crippled in that pot.
This is not the way it's supposed to work with him on the WPT, but tonight, it's going that way.
Well, we've seen Gus in the past at these final tables. It seems like these kind of hands have always gone his way. Tonight, that's not the case. Just a moment ago, he was our chip leader. Now on the verge of extinction.
Gus had the right odds.
So Phil Hellmuth doubles up again.
You got to win the tournament.
He wins a few more pots, Vince. He's going to quiet down these guys.
My name is Phil Hellmuth, and I am the poker brat.
My turn. You know that.
I'm reading well.
Great poker player. Next to me, he's probably the best at the table.
People say, oh, well, Phil, you whine too much at the table.
I knew I'd nail him. I didn't think he'd suck out.
I whine after I lose a big pot.
Oh, no. It's out of a
God,
seat.
Heaven.
I whine if someone's played a hand really badly.
Running seven, that was a bad beat.
That's what I whine about.
He read Phil like a book there, took the pot right away from him.
I'm still frustrated from the poker off the tournament. I mean, I deserve to win that.
I really like the guy, and I think he's a brilliant player. And we all love to make fun of him when he's throwing a tantrum. But you have to respect his game.
Show some class and shake my hand.
I think that I have more knowledge of Texas Hold'em.
Spade, spade.
Than anybody else in the world. I can't walk through an airport without getting mobbed.
Phil is very proud of himself. He's very confident. He believes he's a brilliant person.
I've won more Hold'em titles than anybody else in the world the last 15 years.
Here he is, the poker brat himself.
Although I haven't won a World Poker Tour event yet. Maybe today's the day.
We've just gotten back from a break, and Phil is not back yet.
Oh, and now look at this. Courtney Friel is coming out. They're putting a cut out of him out of the table.
You know, when players don't return on time, the cards are dealt, and you're anteed and blinded off, as we say.
Where's the thing coming out of his mouth that says, I am the greatest?
There's a rumor that Phil actually has about five of these that he travels with and just keeps in his hotel room just for fun.
I hope he makes a scene when he gets back.
So the cutout will play this hand. Action's going to be on Jean Robert.
As everybody gets two cards, they'll kill the hand of the missing player. You saw him do it there.
Jean Robert quickly folding Gus Hansen. Short stack goes out.
Over to Tony G now. He picks up a I'll six high, 6-5 offsuit, and he's going to raise it. 30. Comes in for 30,000.
Splash 30. At the pot. Right behind him, Mike. The mouth has Jack 10.
Mike is going to make the call. Phil, the dummy there, cannot call. He was automatically folded because he wasn't sitting at the table.
Round to mend the master, who's got a suited connector, 10-9 of spades. He's already in the pot.
He's getting pretty good pot odds here. 80,000 in the pot.
Putting the pressure on Mike.
And it cost men 20,000 more to call.
Guess who's coming back? It's Phil.
Well, he's wondering what this statue and cutout is all about here.
I'm going to let this guy take over for me. I'll see y'all later.
We all know the dummy plays better than you.
I mean, the needles never stop with Phil Helmuth. And Men is going to make the call, so we have three-way action.
What happened? They played a hand without me?
Yeah. No, he played
Phil,
for you.
A little shocked, he said, that they played without him.
Well, Phil, believe it or not, they don't stop tournaments when you're not in the seat.
You guys started without
all
me, really?
All right, here we go with a flop. It's a king 7-5. Tony G catches a piece of that.
The master checks.
It's going to be on Tony G. He's raised before the flop.
I'll bet it.
He's going to fire. Only flop bottom 60. Pair.
Mike the mouth going out. And Men out as well. So that's going to do it. A nice little rush here for Tony G.
So by playing aggressive and raising before the flop with six high, betting on the flop, Tony G takes down another pot.
We waited like 5 more minutes.
And Phil, still dumbfounded, believe it or not, tournaments are not held up because Phil Helmuth is not back in the seat.
Well, folks, we got more needles than a sewing factory going on here. Stay tuned. We're coming right back.
I'd like to talk and tell the joke and just have fun when I play. A lot of people love watching me on TV. Not like how a letter is and every style they go.
Welcome back to the World Poker Tour. We're at the Commerce Casino for the Bad Boys of Poker 2. Our current chip leader, Mike the Mouth Matisau, and the defending champion, Gus Hansen, on the short stack right now with 40,000.
Yes, and Phil Helmuth a little antsy. Here he comes.
I want you all to know that I'm the first one in World Poker Tour history to miss a hand.
Oh,
and the cutout was beautiful, beautiful.
He's looking for any kind of record he can get, this guy, Matt. You know what I mean? He's grasping at straws now. You get a feel like that.
Mike would say that the cutout plays better than I do.
Man, it don't take much for anyone to play better than you.
Cruel, okay.
I'm sure the cutout plays
better. Action is going to be on Phil. He's got queen nine this time, offsuit.
Lays it down.
Into men the master. He's got king eight.
Gus already beat him to it.
Certainly not a premium hand, but enough for men to raise with. 30,000 he bets.
Jean Robert out, and now Gus Hansen with a pair of ducks here. Deuces.
I'm not sure.
He's only got 40,000 left.
He knows if he makes this call, probably one or two of the blinds will call also. Going to be tough for him to win a four-way pot with two deuces, so he opts to fold.
All right, I'll leave it up to you two, guys.
Tony out, and now Mike Matisau with the fours.
He just calls, does not re-raise with a small pair. So here comes the flop. And flop is Jack 9-5. As the cards lie, Mike has the best hand with two fours.
Matisau coming out and betting $25,000. Courageous bet.
It's a small bet into a pot that's got over $70,000 in it. And I think Men senses that. And look at this, Vince. He's coming over the top. He is re-raising here with absolutely nothing. Not based on the strength of his hand, but because he perceives weakness in Mike Matisau's hand, and he is exactly right about it.
It's an excellent read here by Men the Master.
Hello, man.
Hello, Mike.
How are you? I make him talk.
Very good. Now he talk. I make him talk.
Men trying to act strong here, and relaxed and confident, and it's going to work.
All you can eat, baby.
He didn't seem nervous one iota. Mike Matisau hitting the trail.
Hello, Mike.
Well, there you get a glimpse of some of the poker skill that is at this table. Men the Master. Re-raising there with no hand and no draw to take that pot away from Mike Matisau.
Just nice thievery by Men the Master, 51 years old out of Bell Gardens. Let's go back down to the table on Tony G. This time he's got ace eight.
Since it's Gus's blind, 25.
He's going to raise it up to $25,000.
Mike Matisau right behind him quickly calls.
Got value, Gus.
Phil Hellmuth with Jack eight behind him goes out.
The Master. He looks down at ace six offsuit and folds.
And Jean Robert going out, and now it's back on Gus. Just a five deuce in his hand. It's going to cost him another $15,000.
Well, he's only got $25,000 left, Vince.
It's desperate times right now.
But he's making the call here.
Yes, he is.
Now he's only got $10,000 left.
35.
He's desperate to try to triple up, but you almost think that if you're going to put in $15,000, just throw out the other $10,000 there and just try to triple up.
Well, we got three-way action. Gus on the ropes here. Here's the flop.
And flop comes King Jack 3. No help for Gus. He checks. Tony, who raised before the flop.
You got to bet $10,000.
Trying to bet $5,000 here.
A little confused here, but he has to bet at least $10,000. He wanted a little bargain there, it looked like. But well, he bets $10,000. And Mike Matisau going over the top of this with his kings.
Not much gets by Mike Matisau. He sniffs out weakness of Tony G there. Comes over the top for $25,000 more.
Oh, this is miserable for poor Gus. He's only got a deuce five at his hand.
He lays it down to save that last $10,000.
And now back on Tony, who has just ace high. Do you want to see the additional $25,000?
Well, I can't see Tony calling here. If you're thinking Matisau's making a play on him, he might come over the top for all his chips, but seems to me those are his only two options.
All right, take it down. Jack's
good. Tony's going to make the good lay down.
Yes, he is.
So Mike Matisau picks up the pot. And here come the Wonder Cam cards. Four and a six. Look at this, Vince. Gus Hansen would have made the nuts. And he just peeked down at the Wonder Cam cards. And right now, he's got to be saying, why didn't I just throw my last $10,000 in before the flop? I would have tripled up.
Well, why did I have to look at the Wonder Cam? I could have been in Monte Carlo and never seen the show. I could have lived happily ever after.
Well, action is on Mike Matisau here.
This time he looks at Jackson 5, Motown.
Does that make you straight?
He goes out. Hellmuth with Jack 3. Goes out as well.
I disagree.
Raise it.
And the Master getting spunky here. He's going to raise with 9-6 of hearts.
Well, it doesn't make much sense to me. He knows Gus is committed to this hand for his little bit of money.
Makes it 30,000 to go. Jean Robert out. Gus has got ace 3.
We're around to Tony.
Tony G with King 7.
It's only 20,000. I know you're going to call.
He's going to make the call. So they have created what's called a side pot. Tony and Men can continue betting on the side. Gus cannot win any of the money that they bet from here out. Here comes a flop. Well, Tony's flopped top pair and quickly checks. And Men has flopped second pair, and he is going to bet.
And the side pot gets bigger. Men the Master betting $30,000 with his pair of nines.
Tony calling him with top pair. Doesn't re-raise.
Not good for Gus sickened by this.
Well, Gus right now has got to catch an ace to take the lead here. Now, deuce comes off.
Tony checks.
This gives Gus a wheel draw as well. He can catch a five and make a straight and win, or catch an ace and win. Remember, Tony and men can continue to bet. Men looking over Tony's chips.
What you got there? About 240?
You're entitled to know how many chips your opponent has, so you can ask for a chip count at any time.
You get a hold of that chips. You can never involve a big pot. How come you got all the chips there, Tony?
That's what I'm trying to work out, too. I don't know. They just come to me. The vacuum cleaner, the Hoover, they call me.
Among other things.
That's your nickname?
Suck them all up. Sometimes, they used to be.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep. Well, man checks right behind him.
Here's the river card. It's a seven. Makes two pair for Tony G.
Tony has now made two pair, kings and sevens. Gus Hansen is going to be eliminated from this tournament.
That's a dangerous card, isn't it?
Well, he says it's a dangerous card because there's three diamonds out there, but it's come diamond, diamond, meaning you wouldn't put somebody on a diamond flush here. So Tony 50. Is going to bet here, 50,000.
Men's pair of nines shrinking up.
Tony checked and called on the flop. He checked on the turn. Now all of a sudden he's betting on the river.
I guess you got nothing the way you look now.
But because Gus is all in this pot, you're just not going to assume your opponent's going to make a play on you with no hand.
He goes out. He knows he can see it anyway.
Well, men makes a good lay down here. Tony G is going to win this pot with kings up.
And that's going to do it for the Great Dane, Gus Hansen. He will become our sixth place finisher here.
The defending champion out in sixth place.
Standing ovation here at the Commerce Casino.
I'll give you a hug, Gus.
That's funny.
He's getting hugs now, man. Even Mattisau, who called Gus an idiot earlier tonight, giving him a hug. He's not hugging back, Vince. He's still wishing he'd put that extra 10,000 in where he made the six eyes straight. So we are going to have a new champion of the Bad Boys of Poker.
And right now, Gus Hansen, not used to getting knocked out of the final table first. He's going to go up to talk to our beautiful Courtney Friel.
You know, there was a lot of trash talking down there. Did you kind of just want to get out of there? Was that irritating you?
No, I'm used to it. I knew they were going to say a lot of both. So I'm just a quiet guy. It's just going to lean back and let them do their trash talking. I mean, it doesn't really affect my play.
There's going to be a new bad boy in town. Don't go away. We're coming back with more on the World Poker Tour.
Welcome back to L.A. and the WPT's Bad Boys of Poker 2. I'm Courtney Friel, and here's what's happened so far.
The first round of this poker brawl went to the newest bad boy in town, Jean-Robert Ballon.
I'm not Bobby. I don't live in this fold.
Next, blowhard Mike the Mouth Mattisau. Humble legend in his own mind, Phil Helmuth. But the mouth had nothing to say when Men the Masson Win came alive with a bold bluff.
Hello, Mike.
Meanwhile, Australian airbag Tony G did more talking than playing, but proved he could walk the walk by taking defending bad boy Gus Hansen out of the game. With one bad boy sent to his room, five are left to fight it out for king of the poker playground.
Five players remain. And right now, the mouth, Mike Mattisau, is the chip leader. The Australian airbag, Tony G, in second with 362. Men the Master with 298. The poker brat, Phil Hellmuth, with 283. And the short stack at this point is Jean-Robert Ballon.
Man, somehow does it seem fitting that Gus Hansen, perhaps the guy with the nicest demeanor at this final table, out in sixth place. After all, this is Bad Boys Night.
Yes, it is. Back down to the table, Jean-Robert quickly folding his hand. And now Tony G has picked up a huge hand, pair of kings.
It's about the standard raise.
Gonna raise it up to 30,000.
Now Mike Mattisau calls him with the ace five of hearts.
Phil Hellmuth quickly out. And Men the Master wants no part of a two-way action right now.
So Tony's got the two kings. Mike has the ace five. Here comes the flop. Jack, jack, four. Action's on Tony. And he's going to bet.
Yes, he does. Splashes 30. And just like that, wow. A quick call by Mike Mattisau with just ace five.
Calling him with the ace high here. Well, a five comes off. These are the chip leaders going at it here.
And Tony has checked. And Mike is coming out to bet 30,000 this time. Well, he got a piece of it.
and a quick call down by Tony G.
Tony, afraid he might have a jack. May have made a spade flush there. Checks and calls on the turn. Ten of clubs comes off. Again, Tony checks.
And Mike checks. Check, check.
Well, Mike trying to see the two fives if they're going to be good. But
you don't have to show me your cards because I know I got you. I just want you to put a bit more money in there. Come on, Mike.
Even when he wins, you're not
happy. Come on, Mike.
What's more, Mike?
I know you better than that.
He's like a circus barker.
Look at Mike Mattisau. He finally lost his voice a little here, Vince. Tony G out talking him. He's silent for the moment.
I thought like he bet the river.
All right, well, the price of poker's going up. $2,000 annies. The blinds are going to be 8 and 16,000.
The Tony G not only talks the talk, he walks the walk. He is our chip leader now.
And Jean-Robert Ballon, Mike, is down to 77,000.
What should we be doing,
man? Back down the table, on the mouth. That's been quieted down. Mike Mattisau, he goes out, Phil out. And now Men the Master with ace nine has gone up to 45,000.
I mean, Men knows I'm calling 99% and raising just 1% of the time. So
Jean-Robert going out. And now Tony G.
He's gonna get a flop against me.
He's got a good hand, King 10.
It's whether I'm gonna raise, that's the thing for him. That's the only decision I have to make. I'll just call.
He's gonna call it, Mike. Ace nine for Men, King 10 of diamonds.
The
very talkative Tony G. Here's the flop.
Under any circumstances.
Wow.
Well, we could see some fireworks here. Tony G's flopped the top two pair. Men the Master has the nut flush draw.
I'm all in.
Tony going all in. He does not want to see another club go off.
Put a little bit of pressure.
And he doesn't want to give the master a free draw in case he's got a straight draw or a flush draw here.
Just
going to put him to the test right now. See if he wants to gamble for all his chips.
You got any clubs in there?
The master with the nut flush draw has got a big decision.
Boy, he sure does, Vince. Now,
pressure.
In poker,
just a little bit of pressure.
You hate it's to put to all your money in a pot
this
on a draw.
This
guy talks about 50 times more than I do.
You may bet the ace high flush draw if it's your turn to bet. Nothing wrong with that. But to call it is another matter. You just hate to put your money in on a draw, especially if you're a top player.
Yeah, Tony G is on automatic pilot right now with a gifted gab.
Like if he calls, you're in trouble.
Am I shaking?
Look at you.
Do I look shaking? Am I shaking at all? I've got two hands out in front of me. Are they shaking?
No, they're not.
They're not shaking because I've got the nerves of steel, baby. And put two hands out in front and not shake. I've got the heart.
Oh, humility not his strong point.
Which is more important than anything else.
The master trying to block it all out, but you know he's listening with one ear, Vance, for sure.
I'm a guy off the street that can play with anyone. That's what I am.
He's telling his life story here.
And I can play
with anyone. But he's right about that.
I can beat anyone on a day.
Bro, can you just keep it quiet, let him concentrate during the hand here?
Well, I'm trying to help him out. He can make a read. He might make a good call. Might look like a champion.
Mike Mattisau telling the other guy to be quiet. That's strong.
That's a great line by Jean-Robert.
Hey, you're right there, Vince. In the meantime, back to Men the Master.
He's calling. He's calling.
You don't think I'm going to call you?
I think you're going to call me.
Right.
I think you're going to call me.
You know how to talk, right?
I don't have to
you
talk.
You know how to shut up if I beat your hand, right?
Of course.
Look at this, it's getting ugly.
I respect you when you beat me.
If I bust your ass, you're going to say nice hand, man.
Yes, uh-oh. I will.
I will?
I'm the first one. If Phil beats
and the master
me,
getting a little edgy here.
Right? I love losing as well as I love winning.
And what Tony G says is true. He's a very good loser when he does
it's
lose
part of
pots.
The game. It's part of the fun. Hey, it's just a WPT title on a line, man. It's not no big deal. One that you haven't got like Phil. Just like Phil, can hold hands.
King of gab.
While you make the decision.
Trying to humiliate.
Let's get the clock out. He needs a clock.
Well, Tony calls a clock on him. Now, most of the time,
sorry about that.
If you're involved in the pot, you're not the guy that calls the clock on your opponent. Tony G has done it here.
Abuse going on here.
He might make a good lay down.
Men has 1 minute to act on his hand. Otherwise, it will be folded.
You're probably making a bad lay down, too. I don't know. What have you got? Do you want to show me one card?
I'm getting dizzy.
Mr. Master?
Mr. Master.
Mr. Master. One card, baby.
Condescending.
Hey, the way he's talking, may get the master to call this hand, man, just to shut him up.
He says, I'll show you one card. It's like a con man in the circus.
Come on, they all want you to call. Nah, he's folding. He's folding. I promise you he's folding.
Oh, boy.
I promise you. A samurai's in business.
This is entertaining. It's everyone except for men right now, anyway. Clock's being counted down. Well, that's it. He didn't act on his hand, so his hand will automatically be folded. But what a laydown. The nut flush. Man shows him that.
I made a great play, man. I made a great play here. The only way I could win this part without gambling my chips was that play.
Well, Tony G saying he made a great play. Let's check the Wonder Cam and see if he did, Vince.
Well, it's a five of spades and a four of spades. So men would not have hit it.
So it turns out men made a great play by laying his hand down.
I also like Tony's move. He didn't want a club to come up. He put the pressure on him. He got to talk for a couple minutes on TV. Well done.
Good play, good play.
Why do you have to respect people on a poker table?
I can see your eyes as well.
It's not the right place to respect people.
You gotta get darker glasses.
My name is Tony G, and they call me the Australian Airbag.
Tony G, he's got no class. It's one thing to have fun at the table, it's another thing to have class, and he don't have any.
It gives you an edge if they get upset at you.
Come on, Tony!
And it puts more pressure on them psychologically. Adrenaline builds up. I get excited towards the end.
But when I kill him, I kill him.
I get very volatile, I guess.
I love it. I want this guy to go.
It's a lot of fun doing it. You should try it.
He is some character, witting and out-talking his opponents. All right, action is going to be on Phil Hellmuth, who has been very quiet tonight. Quiet as a lamb this time. Phil looks at 10-6 of diamonds, throws it away. And we're back on the master.
The master losing his patience.
He's got king five this time.
He lays it down.
And right behind him, Jean Robert is going to go up with king seven of diamonds.
I'm all in.
He goes all in.
I call.
And quickly, Tony G calls him out of the small blind with ace four offsuit.
Mike out. So we have a showdown.
I gotta go.
What a play that is.
This could be the second victim.
As the cards lie, Tony G over a 3-2 favorite to win this pot and eliminate Jean Robert Bland.
Yeah, that's true. He's gonna try to use his rush.
It's a flip. It's a flip.
It's not a flip. You're the favorite.
When you're running, it ain't a flip, baby. When you're running, you know you're good.
So Jean Robert must win this pot to stay alive in this tournament. Right now he's an underdog. Let's see if he can get lucky, win a pot, and stay alive.
Here it comes.
Here's the flop.
Can't wait for a better.
Well, it's come queen, queen, jack.
That's a good flop for you, buddy.
And that's excellent for Tony G out in front with his ace high.
Yeah. You see Jean Robert shaking his head no, looking up to the skies. He knows he needs help. He's got to catch a king or a seven or two running cards to make it straight. Otherwise, he'll be our fifth place finisher.
Yeah.
Here comes fourth street.
Seven.
Well, it's a nine. Now that gives Jean Robert a gut shot straight draw. He needs a king, a 10, or a seven. Otherwise, he is going to be out in fifth place.
He is a dog to do it. He needs some help. Can Jean Robert Ballon do this?
It's a king. Jean Robert has done it. He has caught a king on a river to stay alive in this tournament.
And notice how quickly Tony G threw away the fan as soon as that king hit the board. He gives him a thumbs up.
He took it very well, and he does take beats well at the table. I've played with the guy a number of times, and I'm telling you, he needles and dishes it out, but when he gets beat or takes a bad beat, he doesn't whine about it.
Hey, I'm the first one to put my hands up, baby. You got me. You got me fair and square.
He respects it out. You know, he respects it.
You got me right on the chin, a beauty.
Yes, sir.
His talking is just a weapon for him.
I nearly enjoyed it as much as you did. That is the honest truth.
He is one of a kind, man. You got to say that. Tony G.
As long as he doesn't get beat up at the table, he's doing just fine.
Stress to people that poker's about patience, poker's about attacking weakness. It's not about trying to outplay people. It's about setting people up to get them to give you all their chips.
We're in LA at the Commerce Casino for Bad Boys number two.
And folks, if you don't like trash talking, put your earplugs on, because these guys have been relentless since this game started,
man,
tonight.
Don't be doing that, man.
I do it.
Maybe bet you against me. You got me, but him against me?
Well, right now, they're talking about who's better than who.
No, I wouldn't bet against you.
If we get in there and play a little bit, we'll find out.
Come on, man.
Action's going to be on the mouth. Mike Matisau.
I don't know about the rest of you.
Stops an ace four, and now
Phil Helmuth's got the suited connectors, the 9-8 of diamonds, and he's going to raise it, it looks like, man.
He's got nine bracelets. Seven of them were against 30 people tournaments. I mean, give him a
Phil Helmuth makes it 48,000 to go. But right behind him, Men the Masters got ace queen of hearts.
How bad is that? Well, here it is.
Whoa.
Uh-huh. He has moved in on Phil Helmuth.
He has pushed the buffet tray in.
Jean Robert gets out.
Tony out. They call him and 1% back on Helmuth.
Yeah, but if they re-rate him, it's
Phil
it's
Helmuth. In dire straits here. Phil Helmuth counting it down. Now, Phil shouldn't be touching his chips here, but this is a pet peeve of mine. When a player reaches over and touches somebody else's chips, that's the dealer's job.
Phil's a rookie. You know, what does he know?
150 more.
All right, he finally goes out.
He knows enough to lay down the nine high after the master moves all in.
Show the folks.
So right there, a little poker spanking to that bad boy from Men the Master.
What are you showing that for? That isn't going to do anything. That's going to make him think he's playing good.
I just want to think that the baller Phil, you know?
Nice hammer.
If there is a guy that's a poker pinata, it's Phil Helmuth. Everybody loves to take a swing at this guy.
Phil, that's for sure. If I re-raise, I'll never have that much. I need a 10-7. I had a 10-7. I was dreaming about re-raising.
Well, Mike, watching these bad boys of poker, trash talk really is very entertaining. But there is a line you really shouldn't cross.
Well, Vince, in case you don't watch your language, you could get a penalty that's going to put a bad taste in your mouth, as Courtney Friel found out in this week's WPT Academy.
All it takes is a bad beat and a slip of the lip, and you'll swear that time is not on your side.
Swearing, foul behavior, throwing cards. We have a standard penalty of automatic 20 minutes.
They have penalties in tournaments to keep people from misbehaving too much.
Well, don't get me started there. I think it's the most ridiculous thing in history.
One time!
We have a timer, a little kitchen timer. We set it for 10, 20, 30, 40 minutes, and that's their time away from the table.
You get a penalty in the last three tables, it costs you the tournament. What kind of rule is it?
I definitely have used the F-bomb a few times, but somehow I've never gotten thrown out of a tournament for it or gotten a timeout for it yet.
I never swear. I never abuse the dealers.
And I'm going to take everything you have.
I'm abusing the players within the limits.
I'm going to rip you apart so hard.
I've never had a penalty.
You will never want to play poker again, ever. Got it!
I don't understand the penalty thing. It needs to be removed. It's stupid.
Poker should be more of a gentleman's game.
Come on, man. We're adults.
Yeah, sometimes it just gets a little bit vulgar.
Almost every time, but not every time.
Stupidest rule in poker.
The best way to avoid a penalty is no cussing, no throwing of cards. Take your bad beats like everybody else does, and just behave yourself.
Well, you got to play by the rules. Don't play if you don't like the rules.
These are the greats. These are the best players in the game, the best talkers in the game, the most charismatic, the most on the edge. You got to love these guys.
Yeah, the action's on the poker pinata.
He goes out. Men's got King Deuce of Spades.
And he's going to lay it down.
And now around to Jean Robert. He says raise. He's got a pair of eights wired.
Power, God. Show him the power.
I'm all in.
Ooh. All right, man. Let's go.
Well, Men says show him the power. He's doing it. He's moved all in.
Count it. Count it.
And Tony G is saying, how much you got left? I got ace five in my hand. I might want to gamble with you here.
I know one thing, Bobby. I used to think you were the biggest idiot to ever play with. You actually played good today. I'll give you respect for that.
A lot of slandering going on.
From anybody else at the table, that's a compliment.
Even when they try to compliment Vince, the guy doesn't take it.
From anyone else.
Nobody believes
table,
him here at this table. In the meantime, Tony G is counting out chips here.
I'm just going to see how heavy this is going to be, Bobby.
Could he be thinking about making this call with ace high?
He's probably going to get a bad call.
Big mouse. That's what they called him. Motor mouth. A bat mouth.
Whole table should get duct tape for Christmas.
What's going on, bro?
Yeah.
Give me some love.
Love?
Hey, what's going on, man?
If I love someone, I love better looking guy than you,
Mike. Oh, Vince. This is poker version of the Brokeback Mountain here.
Hold on. They're in a pot here.
Hey, you forgot. Don't tell me you love me.
I do love you.
You're taking a drink, Bobby. You're lucky. If you didn't take the drink, I would have called you. But with that
Tony
drink,
G.
I need to lay down for you.
Don't mind finally the laying it down.
And Jean Robert is going to take down
don't
the
mind
pot.
The fold. Don't mind the fold.
Just a drink. You're in front. I got ace five.
Excellent. Lay down, Ross.
And look at the crowd. They love this guy, Jean-Robert Ballon, the local here from L.A., former nightclub owner. Had a spike, a suck out on the river to stick around.
You're lucky you took a drink. That saved you.
He has come back in a nice way. Welcome back. We're at the Commerce Casino. Bad boys continue. We have five of them here in Los Angeles. And the ship leader at this point is the human airbag, Tony G, with 427,000. And Jean-Robert Ballon is the short stack at this point with 188.
Action is going to be on Jean-Robert here. He looks down and finds two sevens and just calls. He limps in with a pair. I'll tell you what. That unusual play there, I think, for the short stack. But
right behind him, Tony G with King Jack of Diamonds says he's going to raise
75 more.
75,000 more. So a healthy raise by Tony G here.
Mike out, Phil out.
Over to the master. Peeks down at Queen Deuce of Clubs.
By the way, what happened to Men's neck?
Let me look at one more time.
Seems to have disappeared.
And he squeezed out too many hands. Vance has gone away finally.
All right, he goes out. And now Jean-Robert, it's back on him.
It cost him 75,000 more to call.
You can eat, baby.
Well, he got about 170,000 in total left. Vance, I'll be surprised if he doesn't play this pot.
He said he'd drink more than me. No way. No way.
No, but I know it's impossible.
Mike.
And look at the Aussie trying to hush up the mouth. Of all people to say hush up, it's the airbag.
Should I gamble?
Of course they're going to say gamble.
Let's go.
And he does so. He just calls it.
He sort of splashed his chips in there. That's something else you shouldn't do.
Well, these are bad boys. They can get away with it, you know?
I understand.
Got to do things bad if you're a bad boy.
I love the bad boy of poker.
Here we go with the flop.
Flop is queen, four deuce, all spades.
Neither player has a spade. And look at this. John's going to go all in with just the sevens and no spade.
Well, Vince.
How much is that?
Tony says, how much is it? It's about 100,000. I'm a good boy. I mean, Tony only has King Jack. No hand, no draw. Could he possibly call this bet for over 100,000?
I love this hole.
With just King High here.
I love this hole, man.
Well, man loves it, but I'm not sure Tony G does right now, Vince.
Oh, I
I'll call.
Tony G is making the call, Vince, with King High.
Wow.
I got to say, I'm puzzled by this call, folks. I mean, what can he beat? His opponent has to have worse than King High, not have a spade in his hand.
What are you doing, dude?
Jean-Robert is not that strong, but he is out in front with the sevens.
He can't believe it.
No.
He's saying, how could a guy call me with King High?
I put him on a different line, Michael, just a flush.
Come on, hold up, sevens, hold up.
So in the meantime, Tony's got six outs. He's got a king or a jack.
He got six outs.
Mike, of course, we saw Phil Hellmuth fold a king. Mike Mattisau folded a jack.
4-1 favorite.
So a lot of his outs are gone.
Mike says.
We are. That's why people don't have any idea when they miss the flop. I'll be.
Since I'm a 4-1 favorite, I appreciate the call, Tony. Thank you.
You got me. You got me to call. There was so much money in there, I was going to call anything.
Tony G trying to explain the poker logic.
Well, Jean-Robert all in again. He's got to dodge a king, a jack, or two running cards to make it straight.
Yeah, finish it off with a seven.
Well, there's the turn. It's a nine of diamonds. Seven still out in front.
Well, now a 10 wins the pot for Tony G as well. That would give him a straight. So he needs a king, a jack, or a 10.
If he should hit, this would be
come
the
on,
end
deuce.
For Jean-Robert.
Jean-Robert hollering for deuces.
Deuce, baby. Deuce.
Here comes the river.
Well, that's a six. So again, Jean-Robert all in and stays alive. For the second time, he's double through Tony G.
And miraculously right now, Jean-Robert Ballon is now our new chip leader. Australian Tony G quieted down there.
Well, Vince, incredibly, he went from the chip leader to the short stack in one hand.
Nice congratulations.
Well done, Bobby.
Well done, Bobby.
Anybody seen Tony G around here?
Oh, they're mocking him now that he's lost the pot.
Hey, Tony.
Yeah, I'm going now.
Get out the violin.
That's nice. That's poker, isn't it?
He was looking for a king.
Well, the big man getting bigger by doubling up there. In fact, Vince, he has taken the chip lead at this final table by winning that last pot.
Don't forget, the winner will get the WPT Championship seed at the end of the season, and that is potentially worth millions more. Once again, the action on Jean Robert. He throws away 8-5. And right behind him, Tony G has picked up a real hand. Pair of queens.
He bets 50,000. Matisau goes out.
Phil Hellmuth out.
Over to Min, the master.
Min's strategy is gamble.
And he's got a great hand here himself. Big slick, ace king suited.
What two tremendous starting hands.
What Min gonna say?
There you go.
All you can eat, baby!
That's the way Min moves in. He just splashing the pot. Tony G, of course, calling quickly with the two queens.
It is a big clash here. Big slick versus a pair of ladies.
Well, these are two hands that most players are gonna clash with. They have about the same amount of chips, over 560,000 in this pot. Whoever wins it will be our chip leader.
This is a true classic poker hand here.
Who is going to take this one down? Stay tuned. We're coming back with the conclusion of this hand in just a moment. Welcome back to the World Poker Tour. Bad boys clashing here, Mike. Ace king versus a pair of queens.
Well, Vince, these hands play themselves in a five-handed poker game. Very few players are going to get away from either one of these hands. They're all in here. Both have about the same amount of chips. I believe Tony G has him covered by just 1,000 or so, but it's certainly a tight fit. Min has the ace king of spade. Tony G has the two queens.
Here come the first three. What will they be?
Jack, jack, six. Well, Min shoots his arms up in the air, but that's because he's flopped the nut flush draw.
Well, look at this. He is elated. Very excited, he can feel it.
I'm a favor. I got 15 out.
He's saying he has 15 outs.
I'm the small dog. I'm a small dog, now a big favor.
Now he likes his position.
Well, he's looking for an ace, a king, or a spade.
The eternal optimist, Ben the master.
An ace, a king, or a spade. A lot of outs, as we say.
Can he wish it so? Here comes the turn. No, he didn't get it there.
Not so far. Four diamonds on the turn.
Men deflates a little bit.
Well, the master must catch an ace, a king, or a spade.
Of course, if he does not win this hand, the master would have to go back to the Himalayas, where all great masters reside. Can he get lucky?
Well, the deuce of clubs comes off. Now, they may recount the chips here. But I believe Tony G's got him covered.
Min, this is what it was, a coin flip, baby.
Min not leaving the table that made the complete chip count. No, he wants to make sure that Tony G had him covered in chips. I think he sees it now. That's going to do it for the master. Well respected by all these players. What a career he's had in tournament poker.
There's a lot of charity work. Min the master actually built a kindergarten school in Vietnam.
Good hand, man.
But now they're hugging, man. Oh. Well, it's bad boys in the day and kiss and make up at night, man. That's what we're seeing now.
That's right. Tony's the worst player, so that's actually best.
Well, four players left of the bad boys of poker here at the Commerce Casino. This is getting good.
Oh, I thought I won that last hand because of the flop coming to spade. So on the flop, I'm slight favor, but... I could get the call. I'm still happy. I put all in with the best hand. That there's nothing I can do. It's a poker.
Well, Vince, as Muhammad Ali once said, I'm a bad man.
Oh, no.
And right now, the baddest of them all is Tony G. He is our chip leader.
You know, he's an amazing story. As a child, he was the Rubik's Cube champion in Lithuania. That is impressive.
He's got the chips. He's got the heart.
Action's going to be on, Tony. Hadn't even had time to stack his chips yet that he just beat out of Min the master.
Let's see if he's the best.
He just pushes him off to the side here.
He looks down at ace three, says, I'm going to raise it very casually.
I'll make it 40.
And he's going to make it 40,000 to go. Matisau out.
Hellmuth out with queen deuce. And now Jean-Robert Ballon with ace ten of spades.
So auto call.
And auto call?
Auto call.
Puts the goggles on.
So call, 99% call, 1% raise.
I guess he's right, because Jean-Robert is calling.
You're doing the dancing. I'm doing the dictating how to dance.
Knows his man.
I'm the lead.
Ace 10 versus ace 3. Here comes the flop.
And look at this flop, Vince.
Oh.
Jean Robert has flopped the nut flush draw.
Tony G, a piece of it. Pair of threes. Action on Jean Robert to make a move first.
I check.
Well, he's going to check.
All right, let's see a turn.
And Tony checks the bottom pair. First time we've seen him do that today.
All right. Turn cards, a king of club, helping neither player.
All right, let's see the river.
Again, they both check.
Pair the board, and I got it.
Cautious times here. River card coming up.
Well, Tony says pair the board, and I got it. He's right about that. Unfortunately for him, a 10 came up and pair Jean Robert. And now he doesn't have it. Let's see what Jean Robert's going to do. He's going to get a value bet in here, Vince. He thinks his two 10s are the best hand. Indeed, they are.
Well, he sticks in $100,000 for the samurai to think about.
What? 100,000?
Well, Tony G has bottom pair.
I think you had flopped me on this flop.
He says you outflopped me on this flop. Indeed, that's not what happened.
Flopped, all right.
He outdrew him at the river is what happened, but Jean Robert does have the best hand. Will Tony G get away from the bottom pair?
I felt you flopped more
than I flopped. Giving a complete history of the hand.
Well, he does lay it down.
Lays it down.
Excellent lay down, Tony.
And a good lay down it was. Now, Vince, there's a case because he didn't bet on the flop and he didn't bet on the turn. He didn't have any money committed to the pot virtually other than that first $30,000 bet. He opted to lay it down there. A minute ago when he had that king jack of diamonds, after Jean moved all in on him, there was so much out there he felt obligated to call even though he had nothing. So pot odds dictate a lot of what you do, and certainly that applies to the way Tony G plays. And Vince, notice how quiet that Phil Hellmuth and Mike Mattisau have been lately.
It's true. It's like Hellmuth had his tongue cut out. But you know what? He's such a great poker player. He realized. He summed it up. He says, I can't out-talk these guys. I might as well just play great poker. Action on Mike. He quickly goes out.
Mattisau has caught no cards at this table.
You're right. Now Phil's
Phil
out.
Phil doesn't attack me because he knows what's going to happen.
And Jean Robert Ballon with Jack 7.
He's in the small blind. He's going to make the call.
Call the remainder, and Tony G with Queen Jack.
All right.
He says, okay.
I'll dance with you, baby. I'll dance. You got me dancing.
Queen Jack versus Jack 7. Here come the first three.
Oh, Vince, both players have flopped a straight.
Oh, boy.
Tony G has the
nut
straight.
Slow down, Robert.
Jean Robert has the second straight.
They never listen to me when I tell them.
And Vince, there's going to be no saving him here.
It looks like 40,000 and a quick raise by Tony G. We're going to do something where it's so strong that you don't think I'm strong. He's got the cinch at this point.
How much do you want me to raise you? I'll raise you 66,000.
Tony's going to make it 106,000 to go.
This is a slow motion train wreck. You're witnessing firsthand one guy with the smaller straight, one guy with the big straight.
Now, Vince, Jean Robert's in the pickle jar here. He just can't get out of this hand. Nobody in the world can lay this hand down. So I don't know how he's going to save any of his chips in this hand. It's just a matter of when all the chips go in.
Well, not without a performance, though. You got to give him that.
Tony, with the absolute nuts on the flop here, is loving it. And he is just hoping Jean Robert pulls the trigger.
I guess he's raising me.
I'm raising.
Oh, whoa.
Well, he is raising.
Well, he's got to beg for a tie. Here comes the raise.
Before it happens, I know what he's going to do.
Well, Tony says, I know what he's going to do.
Like 140 more.
He's anticipating the raise.
I'll tell you how much you have to raise, Bobby. 140 you got to raise. Oh. I'll tell you how much you have to raise.
He's going to try to orchestrate
his
man.
I'll do the betting for you. You'll dance, and I'll lead you.
Oh.
It looks like the fiddler and the monkey. Is that what this looks like to you?
He's the poker antichrist right here.
You talk more in 20 minutes than I do in a week.
Let's see if my prophecy is right.
I'm raising 139,000.
Well, Tony said he was going to raise it 140,000.
Thank you.
And Jean Robert raised it 139.
Bobby, since you've been such a good partner, I'll just put you all in. Since
I call.
I know you call. I got the max.
Oh, no. Oh. The Eddie Haskell of the poker
Look
world.
Look at this. In an unraised pot.
Well, this is just an amazing hand. Now, it's not totally over. Jean Robert can tie this hand and get a split pot if a queen comes up.
Meantime.
Nice hand, Tony.
That's all he can take for him, though. He must catch a queen to get a split pot.
This will be funny if you get a chop. This will be three bad.
Never take the kimono off. This is the luckiest thing I've ever seen. He's getting the fan out, of course.
He's getting out the samurai sword, and he can do it. Because he's about to take Jean Robert's head off here.
That's tough. Hope the queen comes. There's only one hand that can beat me, and he had it.
Well, bye-bye, Bobby. It's getting ugly in here.
Oh, boy.
Nice hand, Tony.
Wow.
Here we go with the turn card.
Is it a queen? Nope. Not on the turn. Eight of hearts comes off. So we're off to the river. If it's not a queen, where Jean Robert will split this pot, he's going to be out in fourth place.
Could this be the demise of Jean Robert, the local favorite? Here's the river.
Nope, it's a nine of hearts, so that's going to do it. There's nobody at that table that wouldn't have got broke with either Min the Master's hand or Jean Robert's hand back to back.
No, no doubt.
Nothing you can do about it. Jean Robert Ballon out in fourth place.
It was great to get to see him play. A young superstar in the game, Jean Robert. The room is rocking in L.A. We are down to three. Stay tuned. We're coming back with more Bad Boys in just a moment. Well, a devastating defeat for Jean Robert Ballon.
Well, Van, there's nobody in the world that's not going to get broke flopping a straight in that situation like that. Jean Robert Ballon, nothing they could do about it. Out in fourth place. He's up to talk to Courtney.
Thanks, guys. Jean Robert, you were playing such great poker. Were you surprised when you saw the cards?
Oh, I was so surprised. You know, not only, I was just so excited to see the 8, 9, 10 to flop a straight with Jack 7. I mean, I couldn't believe my eyes when I saw that hand. Short-handed, you have the second nuts. I mean, you got to go all the way with it. When he raised me, I was actually more excited because I'm like, oh, my goodness, how many chips can I get him for? And, you know, bad luck.
And Vance, you got to say, this come down to the three baddest boys in the poker world.
The Aussie, Airbag, and Mike the Mouth, and they've actually made Phil Hellmuth seem like a choir boy this evening. $3,000 Annie's blinds are going to be 12 and 24. Action on Phil. Let's take a look at the WPT hole cam brought to you by Budweiser.
Well, Phil looks down a queen five of spades. He's gone all in here.
Yes, he is.
On the first hand, Phil Hellmuth has moved all in.
Tony G quickly folding, and now... Mike Matisau with queen 10 says, I call it.
What a call by Mike Matisau here.
Just an incredible call.
Vance, it took about half his chips to make this call. He did it without hesitation, and it's the best hand. Incredible.
Just a great instinctive call for the mouth.
Good hand, brother.
I can tell you, many players would lay down the queen 10 right there by Mike Matisau.
At least thought about it for about 30 seconds.
But not him. He just felt Phil was going to move in on any two cards. He called him with the queen 10, and he was right in doing so.
Gentlemen, I'm in the five business.
I'm in the 10 business. Put a red 10 and three red cards with a 10 out there. And end this thing up quickly.
You have to say that all day long, Phil Hellmuth's been marching with two left feet. When you say Vance, nothing seemed to be going right for him all day the way he played his hands.
It's one of those nights. Well, he is circling the drain right now.
Well, the flop comes 7-4-3 with one spade. That gives Phil a straight draw, so he can now win the pot if a 6 or a 5 comes off.
Phil definitely won that flop.
As well as two running spades.
Mike is starting to talk to himself there, starting to mumble about more outs. Here we go with 4th Street. In the long run,
with the back door. Well, he had him down to 3 outs before the flop. Now it's 7 outs. Now the king of spades comes off. Look at Mike Matisau. He says, I can't believe it. I had this guy hemmed up as good as you could. And now he's got like 15 outs.
From 3 outs to 8 outs to 15 outs.
Well, Matisau knows it's never easy. And certainly it's not here. Phil Hellmuth looking for a spade, a 6, or a 5.
Here it comes.
Well, it's a king.
Good call, brother. Thanks,
brother. Well, that's going to do it for Phil Hellmuth.
Well, it was a phenomenal read by Mike the Mouth Matisau. The hand holds up, and we are down to two players. Hate to say goodbye to the great Phil Hellmuth.
Wow. Vince, he just never got on track today. Nothing seemed to go his way. Phil Hellmuth out in third place.
I knew Phil was going to raise the button first hand on any two cards.
We are down to two. It is going to be heads-up action between the Australian Airbag versus Mike the Mouth Matisau.
Well, here we go. Time for the money presentation.
Look at this. Sometimes it looks good to be bad. Here comes the cash.
Boy, I'll tell you, they got the handcuffs on, the saddlebags with the cash. Come to put the cuffs on me, Vince.
Take me to your leader.
The $25,000 entry into the WPT World Championship on the line. It is pride. It is ego. It's all rolled into one here. Who's going to take this title?
Tony the Airbag G out in front with 963,000 and Mike the Mouth Matisau with 537 at this point.
And Vince, if you took a ballot among the players as to who were the two biggest trash talkers in the poker world, without question, these are the two guys that would appear on almost every ballot.
So don't tell me that trash talking doesn't help your poker game. Action's going to be on Tony G. And look at this. With just 10-4, he's going to raise it an additional 50,000 right out of the gate.
Well, Mike Matisau with a queen nine of spades going to look him up and give him the call.
He's going nowhere. Good pot on the very first one. Here we go.
And here comes the flop. It's come 6-6-5.
No help to either player.
Mike checks it.
I'm 100.
And Tony G bets 100,000.
With absolutely nothing, and he gets Mike to lay down the very first hand. Vandalized Mike Matisau right there. The Australian airbag trying to shush people because he realizes that we see that he was betting on absolutely nothing. Do you think this man has the right to ever shush anybody? What do you think? I mean, it just doesn't make sense to me.
You make a good point there, Vinny. Round one of this championship fight going to Tony G, and he earned it, Vince.
All right, action's going to be on the mouth. Mike Matisau. Right back on him. He's got a three deuce of clubs this time.
Well, he's going to lay it down.
You just do the camera. I don't even want to touch it.
And look at this. Tony G gets the ground skinner with the worst hand you can have in poker, the seven deuce offsuit.
So things are going his way right now.
I don't care.
Been playing poker for 20 years. Has an opportunity to take his first WPT title.
It's a matter for Mike to get a good hand because he knows he's going to be all in the first one he does. I hope it's better than mine for you. And I hope it's better than yours for me.
Well, he's even confused me by saying all that.
Who gets the best hand? This is the trick now.
The arrogance has not gone down on any level. Right back on him. This time he's got 6-4 offsuit. Says he's going to call it.
Well, he's won the first two pots with a 10-4 offsuit and a 7-deuce offsuit.
Mike has got queen-deuce. Says, I'm content to see the flop. Here we go.
Now, flop is 9-7-3. Tony G has a gut shot straight draw.
I got to check. I honestly,
Mike Matisau has nothing but queen high.
Matisau checks.
Backdoor chop. All right, I check it.
Well, Tony's also going to check. The ten of spade comes off. Now both players have a flush draw, but Mike Matisau has the queen high flush draw.
Well, he bets an insy bet, $25,000. See if he can pick up this pot from Tony.
Well, you would think he could. Tony has a 6-4. He does have the 4 spade, but if a spade comes up, that's just going to lead him to trouble. He's making the call, though, Vince.
He's going to splash around. Here we go to the river. It's a jack of clubs. Helps neither player.
Mike checks.
100.
Tony, he's going to bet $100,000.
Well, there's a case, Vince, that had Matisau bet.
Oh.
He most likely would have won that pot. Instead, he checked. Tony G took that opportunity and bet. Well, he is outplaying Mike Matisau right now, Vince. No doubt about it. It's two consecutive hands. He's had no hand, no draw, and he's won both pots.
What's more impressive than that, he's actually made the mouth shut up. Hasn't said a word in a few hands. This is a first for WPT.
But it's easier to outplay Mike Matisau than that talk him, I can tell you. Tony G doing both right now.
Welcome back to the World Poker Tour. Bad Boys continues. Heads up battle. Tony G manhandling Mike right now. Tony G's got about $1.1 million and Mike down to about $395,000.
Action's on Matisau. Oh, look at this, Vince. He's picked up two kings on the button and just limps in, trying to trap Tony.
Yes, he is. Now, Tony's got 10-8 of diamonds. Will he fall for this?
What have you got?
340.
I'm over.
I call. Oh, he's gone all in.
Well, he fell right in the trap, and Mike Matisau trapped him. Look at the excitement of Mike Matisau there.
He might still lose.
He knows if he wins this pot, he'll be the chip leader in this heads-up match.
What an opportunity for Mike the Mouth to double up here.
And he's about
a sweet revenge.
Yeah, he's about a 4-1 favorite to do so, Vince.
That's my lucky hand of the whole world, Mike. I tell you what, that hand is my lucky hand.
Now look at
this.
The
only reason I did it, so.
The Aussie saying this is my lucky hand, my fate hand. We will see. He's going to need a lot of luck to suck out on this.
I hope it's interesting at least, right?
Well, you got to salute Mike Matisau. He knew Tony was playing very aggressively. He limped in on the button. Tony moved all in. He called him. He's way out front. Let's see if he can hold him and take the lead here.
Here come the first three.
Oh, boy.
And he's blocked a 10 and an 8.
Wow.
Wow.
Holy smoke.
Oh, just no. An incredible flop for Tony G right there. Mike Mattis out laughing about it. Can't believe it. And just that quick from being a 4-1 favorite to win this spot and double up to a 70% underdog with one flop.
And look at the Aussie airbag. Oh.
Well, right now, he's got about 6 inches of that samurai sword in Mike Mattisau's gut.
And here we go with the turn card.
Mike Mattisau looking for a king or deuce to take the lead.
Uh-oh.
Well, the nine of hearts comes off.
Deuce, nine.
Pair the board, anything.
Now, Mike Mattisau is going to need a king, a nine, or a deuce to stay alive in this tournament.
Otherwise, it will be over. The Aussie airbag will take this title. River card coming up.
If this wins, this is going to be...
Mike Mattisau still looking in disbelief at those cards that are out there. Well, it's a queen. Tony G has done it. He bows to the crowd. He is the Bad Boys champion. Mattisau doesn't even feel bad, Vince, I guarantee it. He played that end to perfection. He trapped his opponent for all his money. He was a dominating favorite. Unfortunately for him, didn't work out.
It is only correct that the greatest trash talker in the game, Tony G, takes his title.
Talk to our runner-up, Mike the Mouth Mattisau from Las Vegas, Nevada. Mike, you know, you trapped your man perfect there in the heads-up situation. Didn't work out for you. Runner-up tonight. Tell us how you're feeling right now.
I'm feeling good. Luckily, it wasn't for one of those $2 million or I'd be out, like, dumping the tables over.
Well, Mike, here's what we really want to know. You think this guy can out-talk you?
Oh, hell yeah.
Mike Mattisau, our runner-up. Thank you, Mike. Now let's talk to our champion from Melbourne, Australia, Tony G. Tony. Tony, I'll say one thing. You talk the talk, and tonight you walk the walk. Congratulations. Tell us how you're feeling right now.
Thank you very much for those words. I feel really great. I feel very humbled because I was very lucky. It's a hard life to come off the street and become a great poker player. That's fantastic for me.
Well, you came out as a samurai tonight, and you sure cut them all down. You are our champion. Congratulations. And now it's time to toast our champion with Budweiser, the official beer of the World Poker Tour. Here's to the baddest of them all, Tony G from Melbourne, Australia, our champion in Bad Boys of Poker 2. Vince Van Patten, and everyone on the World Poker Tour, I'm Mike Sexton Sand. Thanks for watching. And until next time, may all your cards be live and your pots be monster.
I don't understand what this is for.